Hey y'all, Merry Christmas. Today we celebrate the Feast of the Holy Innocents, Martyrs. When King Herod finds out that the Magi have deceived him, he orders the slaughter of every boy aged 2 and under in Bethlehem and the surrounding area. It's important for us to acknowledge that so many lives were lost, so much innocent blood was spilled, much like today. The heinous act of abortion causes millions and millions and millions of innocent lives to be destroyed. It's important for us to remember that as Christians, that we're called to protect each and every single one of these vulnerable lives. On the other hand, I do want to focus today for the Feast of the Holy Innocents on Saint Joseph. Now that Pope Francis has declared it a year of Saint Joseph, which is very exciting for those of us who are devoted to him, one of my very favorite nicknames for Saint Joseph is the Terror of Demons. Can you imagine being called the Terror of Demons? Just the sight of you, just your presence makes demons flee in terror. And one of the reasons why is because of what we hear in the gospel today. It's Saint Joseph that's called to protect our Blessed Mother and our Blessed Lord. It's Saint Joseph that's called to guide them to safety, to lead them as the head of his household. And I know there's a disconnect with our Protestant brothers and sisters about us calling upon the intercession of the saints, but let's think logically about this for a second. If Jesus is God, and God picked his own parents, he was able to choose his mother and his father, wouldn't he have picked the best of the best? Wouldn't he have chosen excellency and perfection and holiness and righteousness? And if he spent 30 out of his 33 years in the private life of this holy family, ought we not to pay attention to that? Isn't that something that's significant? Doesn't Jesus speak to us very specially, very specifically through the way he chose to spend his earthly life? He spent only 3 of it in public ministry. The rest of it was with Saint Joseph and our Blessed Mother. And if Saint Joseph is the one who taught and formed Jesus into the man that he grew up to be, into the man that you and I love, can he not do the same with us? One of my very favorite reflections a priest shared with me, and this is not a dogmatic teaching, so you don't have to believe it or not, is something called the Assumption of Saint Joseph. And saints have written about this before. But can you imagine, in all his time with Saint Joseph, Jesus very likely shared his plan, his salvific plan from the very, very beginning. He opened up, it's very likely he opened up the scriptures to Saint Joseph and shared the bountiful riches that was God's plan from the very beginning with him. And so if he said, I'm gonna grow up to be just like you, Dad, I'm gonna grow up to imitate you, I'm gonna grow up to be a good man just like you are, and you just watch, Dad, I'm gonna save the world and there's gonna be no more suffering and no more sorrow. And can you imagine that after Jesus plunged into the depths of hell and ascends into heaven, if he raises up Saint Joseph with him? Like any good son, wanting to make his father proud, would be able to say, I did it, Dad. I told you I would. I promised I would. I saved everyone. God bless you on this Feast of the Holy Innocents, and may Saint Joseph intercede for all of us.